Hello and welcome to History Pod. On the 5th of February 1924, the BBC Pips were broadcast for the first time. The BBC had successfully broadcast the chimes of Big Ben for the first time at New Year 1924. This led the Astronomer Royal, Sir Frank Watson Dyson, to suggest that reliable time signals should be broadcast more regularly. Having convinced BBC boss John Reith of the idea, the pendula of two mechanical clocks at the Royal Greenwich Observatory were fitted with electrical contacts that sent a signal to the BBC every second. It was agreed that five short pips would signal the 5 seconds leading up to the hour, with a slightly longer pip marking the start of the new hour. Although now largely inaccurate as a result of the inherent delay in the encoding, transmission, and decoding of digital radio broadcasts, the pips are still a part of many BBC radio programmes. The equipment that generated the pips moved from Greenwich in 1939, but the pips are still known officially as the Greenwich Time Signal. The name was even kept after the Greenwich Time Service stopped transmitting the pips in 1990. Since then, the BBC has generated the pips using an atomic clock situated in the basement of Broadcasting House. Since they're used as a time signal, the BBC doesn't allow programmes to broadcast the 6-pip sequence for any other reason. Until recently, the BBC also discouraged its broadcasters from crashing the pips, which involved playing any other sound at the same time. Although the rule against crashing the pips is now less rigorously enforced, some BBC Radio 4 listeners still wait with bated breath to hear a presenter accidentally talk over the...